Excuse me. Okay, now I'm going to assemble this microphone stand and hook up the mic to the mixer. So here's how it looks. Let's see. How am I going to do this? Oops. I'm going to put the... Let's see. I'll put the tripod here. Okay, so the camera's pointed down there, okay. Okay, this should work. Okay, now that board tells me what's in the field of view. Okay, so these are the parts. So start with the bottom, and you put it in where the legs are. Push it up through, and then clamp it. So that's the bottom. Okay, and then the top. This is the boom, which can come, if you take the ring out, this boom comes off. But I'll leave it on. And this goes in here. Let's see, can you see that? Maybe not. Okay. That you get the idea. Okay, so. Okay, here we go. Okay, so this goes in there, and then you tighten that. So now the bottom and the top are tight. And then let's go to the top here. Let's see. It's pretty obvious. Okay, so there's the boom. This loosen that, bring that out, tighten it, and you put on the microphone holder. Goes in there. This is hard to do with one hand. Okay, it's pretty obvious. Okay, now we will tighten it and set it up. So everything is adjustable in every direction. Okay, so you will probably won't have any trouble figuring it out. So I'm going to stop here and move it over to the mixer area. Okay, so here's the mic. And let's see. Okay, now. Okay, so you put the mic in the holder, and then you start to tighten everything. So let me do the tightening. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see this. So I'll tighten the mic, push it in, make sure that's tight. I'll set it level to my mouth, tighten all the stuff, and then there you go. So that, and tighten. Okay, depending upon how you want to do it, you can make it more or less tight. Okay, that's good enough for me. So now, let me show you the finished product. Okay, so the stand's down there. This is tight. this is tight, this is tight, this is tight, the mic is tight. So the mic is pretty stable, except the floor is a little, it's on a little wobbly thing. But anyway, that the mic now is close to my mouth, and it won't move easily, but I can, if I force it, I can make minor adjustments. So you don't want to hold it or touch it or bang on it, but you want to be able to position it easily. So now I can talk into it, and next thing, be able to hook it up. Okay. Now the mics always have this kind of input, almost always. Can't think of any exceptions. And they need some gain, so they have to go into one of the first two channels. So I'll put it in number two. Doesn't make any difference, one or two. Okay. Now, so now I have the computer hooked up. This. Now I realized before when I looked at that last video that you couldn't see some of these things. So I'm going to go through a little bit of this again with holding the mic in a better way. Let's see if I can. Of course, at home, you can route these cables much better than what I've got here. Another thing I noticed, I'll mention, is there's a tiny wobble in this case. And I have these, a solution for that. They're these little rubber feet. I put them on all my equipment, and almost everything I have has little rubber feet in it. My speakers do, the preamp does, everything. And those little rubber feet, they're silicone, they absorb a little bit of shock. They're very small, you know, it's not very thick. There's a whole lot here. So you just put four of them underneath in the four corners, and it won't slide around, and it won't wobble. You can do the same thing with the Lexicon if you want. And I wouldn't do it for the speaker, because you're going to move that around. Anything else you like. So that's good to have. Another thing that's nice are these, this tape, mixing tape. There's nothing special about it, except that they call it console tape. All it is white tape that's non-gummy, and you write on it. As you can see from the picture there, the guy took his mixer and put a strip of the tape on the bottom and said, you know, the first one is vocal one, then vocal two, then guitar, then bass, and then saxophone, and then drums. So that's kind of cute. So you take that tape and then just put it across here, and then you write on it with what's on those channels so you don't forget. It is easy to forget sometimes. And then you just peel that off when you're done. It's not sticky. It won't fall off, but it's not going to get gummy. So that's another nice thing to have. Okay, so let's see. So the microphone is now on, and it's connected here. So I have microphone, computer, and then output to the speaker. Okay, so microphone's here. Now I need to adjust levels. Now I know that the microphone is going to need some gain. So I'll start with it in mid-gain, and then go to the level here and bring it up. Bring it up all the way. There we go. Ooh, it's on. Ooh, forgot. Okay, there we go. Now, I'm going to get feedback if I turn it too loud. But the nice thing about these mics are this particular brand. He's the feedback. This, if I put my hand just right, it's going to bounce off the speaker. And they're very directional, which is great. So they don't pick up very much from that. I'll have to move it out of the way. Okay. They don't pick up very much. And you can see that's a fairly comfortable level now. When I get close to the mic, here I am, right on top of it. Okay, well, the feedback I'll have to live with. But normally, you would be putting the headphones in, and where's the headphone out? Headphone. Here, up here. This top thing of the headphone jack. So you could plug the headphones in when you're setting things up, and you won't get that. And if you don't have the microphone on, then you can hook the speaker here. But as you can see, even with it really close, if you're careful, you won't get any feedback. At least it won't be too bad. All right, so that's there's the mic. So you could be using your flute recorder. And hold on a second. I have some more stuff here for you. Okay. So here, I have a flute. I mean, flute recorder, you know what I mean. And I can't hold the speaker and blow at the same time, but... And I can't play at all. I have it. I don't know why I have it. Somebody gave it to me, I guess. And, let's see. This is a slide whistle. Now, the recorder can only play the notes that are it's programmed for, and a program built for. There's no middle notes. Maybe there's some ways to fake it out. But the neat thing about a slide whistle is you get any frequency you want. So, get it. So there it is. You blow into it, and like a flute, and you slide the chamber plunger so it goes. So you get any pitch you want. Okay, so that's kind of neat. I don't know why I have it, but it's another one of those things. And then here's another thing, acoustic, and here's a little mouth organ or harmonica. So, you can use the mic to record those. Okay, now... So with the mic, I think the mic seems to be set up. Oopsie, bump it. Okay, I think the mic is set up okay. I did it all by ear, which you really need to do for everything. You want to set the first gain to the minimum, and still get enough volume. And then this probably like that, and then testing 1, 2. That works good. Okay, not too much feedback. Yeah. Okay, so I could probably live with that kind of setting and use the mic. And the gain is not very high, so there's not going to be a lot of noise from this, so that'll work pretty good. And with the headphones off, with the speaker off, where you can turn this down. And if you put on the headphone jack, you'll see that it's got its own volume control. So you can turn the volume up on the headphones and talk into the mic and hear what it'll sound like. And then when you got everything set up correctly, you can then go and turn on the speakers. So that's nice, having a headphone jack separate. So that's why there are so many knobs here and things like that. I'll go through some of the other possibilities. Now, this is called Phones and Control Room. The phones are at the top. Control room is next to it. Those are extra outputs. And the phones, as I said, are for your headphones with their own volume control. The same thing that can be sent to the mixer could be sent to the phones or control room. But they're independent volumes. And the purpose of the control room would be for, like, if you're on a performance stage, the control room would be the guys running the lighting, and maybe they have control of smoke signals and fireworks and all that kind of special effects. So they need to hear the mix as well that's going up, but they may want it at a different level. Also, there's two extra things here. There's the two-track output and input, and they're just some stereo, extra stereo inputs and outputs that you normally, the two-track input would be sent to the control room, and it's a recording of instructions. Like it might be a timeline, you know, set at 2 minutes and 30 seconds, the person's going to come in, so turn on light number 5. And that's on a CD or a tape recording or something else. It could even be a computer or something. And those signals, you only want to send to the control room, but you don't want to send to the speakers. So you want to switch them. And the outputs are if you want to get your own little private recording of the event live. You put the, like that recording device I gave you, the Tascam, in here, and you can record directly from the mix. And there's various buttons to switch things around. So this one sends the two-track to the control room, and this one sends the two-track to the mix, which means if you put the two-track here, sending it to the mix will send it to the speakers. So you can send them both. If they're both down, then the two-track input gets sent to the control room and the mix. The mix means the output, the speakers. If they're up, then they're off. Phantom over here refers to what's needed for high-quality speakers. You don't need them for this, the speaker that I gave you. But I do need them for my other speaker. And that's, if you need it, you need it. You press it on, and then it sends power to the speaker jack. So you don't want that on for this speaker. And that's 48 volts. So when you press it on, that little red light says plus 48 will come on. And it won't hurt the speaker, the microphone, if it doesn't need it. Like this mic does not need phantom power. It doesn't need any power at all. So pressing that in or out won't make any difference. But you wouldn't push it in normally. Okay, now the next thing are the aux. That's where things get interesting. And that's this red row here, and this return, and some send. Now this is where the lexicon comes into play. And I'm going to stop here, and, well no, I guess I won't. We'll hook it up. Now maybe I'll stop here and get the hookup set so I can find the cables first. I'll stop here.